everybody, it's Ingrid from Twinkl, and today I'm going to be talking about rounding numbers up and down and estimating answers. Rounding numbers up or down is helpful because it can make estimating faster and easier. For example, 13 plus 39 would take a bit longer to do in your head than 10 plus 40. Now we know that 10 plus 40 isn't going to give us the exact answer, but it will give us a rough idea of the number we're looking for. 10 plus 40 is 50. We can estimate that 13 plus 39 would equal something in the vicinity of 50 without having to do the maths. When rounding numbers, the most important thing to remember is that if a number ends in 0, 1, 2, 3, or 4, you're going to need to round it down to the nearest 10. If it ends in 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9, you're going to need to round it up to the nearest 10. For instance, the number 13 ends in a 3, so we're going to need to round that down to the nearest 10, which is 10. The number 39 ends in a 9, so we're going to need to round that up to the nearest 10, which is 40. This Estimating Answers worksheet from the Twinkl website is a great way for learners to practice rounding numbers up or down to help them estimate answers to sums. It provides a list of sums and spaces to round the numbers up or down and calculate a rough answer. There's also an answer sheet, so learners can check their work afterwards or switch with a friend and mark each other's answers. When rounding decimals, this process works in much the same way, except instead of rounding whole numbers, you're going to need to round decimals. If it ends in a 0.5 or anything larger, you're going to need to round it up to the nearest whole number. If it ends in a 0.4 or anything smaller, you're going to need to round it down to the nearest whole number. For example, 5.5 ends in a 5, so we'd need to round that number up to a 6. If our number was 3.2, we would round that down to a 3. Twinkl has a handy worksheet for rounding decimal numbers like this as well, and this one comes with a scale, so you can visually see where the number would be, making it easier to see whether it needs to be rounded up or rounded down. That's all for now, but if you'd like more resources on how to estimate answers or round numbers, there are plenty of options available on the Twinkl website, so make sure you check that out as well. Thank you so much for watching, and have a lovely day.